in our youth ministry when I was younger. And so when I was first asked to testify, I was like, usually when you say testimony, it starts with, I used to be like this, and this is what God did to my life, and so now this is how I live. It's usually like that. And it's quite different for me because I grew up in a Christian family. I was brought up in a Christian environment. And so I was like, you know, how am I supposed to testify when I really have nothing particularly horrible happen to my life, thank God. But we all know that, you know, God doesn't just work on, he doesn't have a formula when he works on our lives. And so I still believe that there's a reason for why I was brought up the way I was, and there's a reason for why I am the way I am. And, you know, I'm hoping that, you know, God will just use me today and speak to you and touch you. And turn to the person next to you, please, and tell them, Diyos ko, sana may mapulo tayo sa kanya. Okay. Okay, let's start to the verse. This is my favorite verse. I believe it was on the poster. It's from Jeremiah 29:11. I'll read it from the Message version of the Bible. It's my favorite version of the Bible. It says, I know what I'm doing. God says, I know what I'm doing. I have it all planned out. Plans to take care of you, not abandon you. Plans to give you the future you hope for. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity for us to gather as a family, Lord God, as soldiers, as part of one army, battling through life together. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that you just use this evening to minister to us. I pray that you prepare all of the hearts. Prepare the hearts to receive your word, Father God. Speak through me. I have no agenda, Lord. You know that. Kayo na po ang bahala. Gamitin niyo po ako. And we thank you, Father, and we invite you to come and stay. We ask your Holy Spirit to just minister to us. And we thank you, Father God. In your name we pray. Amen. Okay, so testimony. Wala nga akong horrible past. So I guess I'll have to share with you the kind of life that I led. Hi, G. You're so beautiful this evening. Hinanap talaga kita. Where's G3? Okay, anyway, so I will share with you the kind of life that I had. I received Christ when I was 11 years old. Dahil nga, I was born into a Christian family. My parents met in church. They were in the choir together, singing, and my dad was playing the piano, and God knows they were flirting. But then so, that union resulted in me. And so I grew up in a Christian environment. Went to Sunday school religiously. Attended DVBS. Sino po may alam ng DVBS? Yes. My idol was Salty. And so I was that kind of kid. I would give my tithes and offering faithfully, kahit piso lang yan, because those were the kinds of things that, you know, were instilled in us at a very young age. And so I got a bit older, and nagkaroon ako ng sarili kong malay. So at 11 years old, I decided to seriously give my life to Christ. And this was during a youth camp or a youth conference or something like that. And so that was when, like, the serious journey began. And that was the time na hindi na kinilangan ipilit ng mga magulang ko na magsimba ako. I went on my own. And so I was 11 years old then. I grew up in a Christian home. I went to a Christian school. It was called Shekinah Christian Training Center. How Christian can that get? It followed a system called ACE, Accelerated Christian Education. So believe it or not, part of the curriculum was memorizing verses of the Bible. You will not pass the exam if you do not memorize the verse in the Bible. New King James Version pa. Wow. So talagang good luck. But so yun yung kinalakihan ko. I went to Christian school. I attended. I was part of our youth ministry, our youth choir. I was part of the worship team in church. Although you know my adolescent life was pretty normal. I also still competed in mga inter-school singing competitions, elocution contest, whatever. And but other than that, it was normal. My friends were Christian. My whole family were Christians. We all went to church together. And so I guess it's safe to say, and my mother is here to confirm that, I wasn't a headache, was I? No, I wasn't a headache. Okay, I was a good girl. No boyfriend until I finished school, except for one minor error. But wala natin yung sa nakaraan. And so, sa tao mo dyan, happy here. And what else? I was very into my academics. People graduated valedictorian, ganyan, Christian Character Award. Hardcore talaga. So, in fairness naman, you know, I thought my future was fairly predictable. So all of my church mates would say, okay, so we know what's gonna happen to her in her life. She's gonna finish school, she's going to marry some good Christian boy without tattoos. No, she's gonna marry a good Christian boy from a hardcore Christian family. And they're gonna have children, and she's gonna send them to DBBS and Sunday school also, and just repeat the whole cycle. So, you know, it was really predictable, my future. And I was comfortable with that. I was comfortable with my Christian environment. I was safe. I was in my comfort zone. Until, ito na yung sinasabi ni Chit, the Coke commercial happened. How that came about was, if I may share, I've always wanted to do a commercial, and I remember distinctly writing it down in my journal that I just wanted to do one commercial in my life that people would not forget. I didn't know what that was gonna be, but I was, what, 14 years old? I wish I took a photo of the journal entry, but clearly says, just one commercial. I don't know why. I didn't want to be an artista. I didn't want to be a professional singer. I just wanted to, you know, I just happened to know how. I never really joined mga Metro Pop or whatever, singing for the star, Chuba. And so I just really wanted one commercial. And so this Coke thing came along. I auditioned, was rejected. No, hindi ka kasama. And I was used to that. So the Coke commercial was the last thing I ever auditioned for because I was kind of like my self-esteem was medyo okay. Kota na ako sa rejection, tama na. And so so that's the last thing I auditioned for until I got a phone call that said, "Can you make it to the recording studio in parang in like 4 hours, something like that?" I was in school. I was 17 years old. I was a freshman in Ateneo, still battling with the changes that I had to go through in the college world. And so they called and said, "Can you get to the studio at this time?" And I was like, "Okay, I'll cut class for that." So I did. And they told me that I got the commercial. I was their second option. Nagkataon, yung first choice nila, some issue about like a contract or whatever, didn't want to do it. And so as the second option, they gave it to me. So nun pa lang, you can already see God working. You can already see God's hand upon the situation na of all people, of all the things that could have happened to that girl, sa akin pa mauuwi ito. So I did the commercial, was happy, checked that thing off my life bucket list, whatever. And so I thought that was the end of it. Until the network, which we all know as ABS-CBN, started calling and mix, and I was just getting all of these offers and invitations to join the very crazy jungle called show business. And so, syempre, you know, you were like, you know, ay, teka lang, let's think about this, let's pray about this, you know, it's like it's so far from what I'm used to, from the kind of world that I grew up in. And so we were like, okay, sige, let's pray about it, and then let's consult our church mates or the family. Or so we did. We prayed. But then again, you know, alam naman natin lahat ng mga bagay may timing. At sa ABS-CBN, ang timing natin isa lang, ora-orada. Lahat ng mga bagay, ora-orada. Kailangan isabi, now na. That is the time frame, the schedule here in ABS. Now na. And so, they needed our answer now na. Hindi na namin magawang mag-survey pa na, sa tingin niyo ba, dapat mag-showbiz siya. Hindi na namin kinayang ikutin yung barangay para tanongin kung tama ba yung desisyon namin. And so, you know, we consulted the close friends that we had, and they were all saying the same thing. Don't do that. They all knew that the kind of world that I was used to, they all knew that I was naive and frail and fragile, and they all knew that I wouldn't survive it. They all said the same thing. It's a lion's den. Show business is a lion's den. It's a jungle. It will eat you up alive. It will tear you apart. The system will eat you up. Masisira ang pag-aaral mo. Mabubuntis ka ng maaga. And all of these things, right? And so, hindi ka muna mamatakot nun. But there's a verse in the Bible. My mom and I, we had a revelation, if you will. We were thinking, you know, God would not have opened this door of opportunity for me had He not purposed it to happen at such a time as this. You know, the timing was insane. And na-realize namin that there must be a reason for all my involvement in the arts. Must be a reason for why I trained in acting and in singing, and why I joined all of these art stuff in high school, and my involvement with the church praise and worship ministry. I was currently leading praise and worship for the youth then. So we were like, there must be a reason for why, you know, all of these things just dropped in our laps. And then God spoke to us, gave us this verse, clear as crystal. This is from the NJB version of the Bible. That's New Jerusalem version, I think. Isaiah 43 verse 21 says, "The people I have shaped for myself will broadcast my praises." Broadcast. That word just like stood out for me. "The people I have shaped for myself will broadcast my praises." And with that verse in hand, we signed our first contract in ABS-CBN. And so, I thought, you know, ito yun eh. Ito yung dahilan. The word broadcast says it all for me. This is the reason. It's not, hindi lang pangbanyo yung training ko sa kanta. Hindi lang, you know, ang aso ko ang makikinig sa akin pag kinausap ko siya. God wanted to use me as an instrument, and that was, you know, what we were holding on to when we signed our first contract. So, you know, I thought the challenge would end there. We already decided. But no, it did not end there. Now, the problem for me was I had two circles of people watching me. I had the Christian circle watching me, and then I had a showbiz circle watching my every move, scrutinizing. Inaabang, I felt like I was walking, naglalakad ako sa tightrope, like every move I make, meron silang sasabihin about it. So, you know, I was having the hardest time trying to marry my values with my craft. It was no picnic at all. You know, you have one circle here, the showbiz circle, saying na, ano ba yan? Manang-manang yan. Ba yan? Wala tayong magawa dyan. Hindi na payubaran yan. Ano ba yan? And then you had the Christian circle saying, "Why? Dahil yung babay kinanta niya sa ASAP? Don't you wish my girlfriend was hot like me? Ano ba yan? Di ba nag-lead lang siya ng praise and worship sa..." So, you know, I was having the hardest time trying to marry the two. And it was just so difficult because I felt like we reached the point of loneliness. We felt like we were so alone. We wanted to hold on to the things, to my principles, to my values. But at the same time, you know, this is show business. You know, this is show, this is entertainment. I still had to prove that I was made of the right showbiz stuff. There must be a reason for why the network, you know, got me and employed my services. And so, I did my best not to compromise. But at the same time, yun nga, kinailangan kong may patunayan naman ako na tamang kinuha niyo ako at may rason kung bakit niyo ako kinuha. So, medyo mahirap because, you know, amidst all the noise and all of the noises in my head, the silence of my friends, where the silence is very, parang mas maingay pa siya sa akin na yung mga taong, you know, you're relying on these people to pray for you because you belong to the same family. They weren't. Instead, they were so quick to judge. They were so talagang nakatutok na, paikli na paikli yung panda niya na. O, palalim na palalim yung v-neck niya, neutral na yung ano niya. So, parang ang hirap-hirap, gumalaw. And so, you know, at that point of loneliness, they were saying na I was already changing, and then the other people naman sa showbiz circle were saying, "Ano ka ba? Nag-aaral ka pa?" I mean, believe it or not, di ko na lang babanggitin kung sino, but I actually received a threat or an offer or a threat from a director to stop schooling. He was like, "No, hindi ka pwedeng maging estudyante dito sa set ko. Estudyante ka or artista ka, pumili ka." And so, ito yung mga bagay na pinagdadaanan ko, and hindi ko malaman kung saan lulugar. And syempre, dadagdagan pa natin dyan ng internet. The very wonderful comments that you read on the internet. You know, just people randomly saying the most hurtful of things. I find myself sitting in front of the computer crying and thinking, you know, what did I ever do to deserve this kind of treatment and comments from random people. Ultimong virginity ko pinakailaman. And so hirap na hirap ako kasi it's just, you know, what am I gonna do? I, Lord, akala ko may rason. Bakit parang naiipit ako dito? Bakit parang nawala yung purpose? And so, it brought me to the point of just trying to offer to God everything that was happening to me in my life. I still strongly believe that there was a reason for why I am the way I am and I'm in the industry. Hindi naman ako, wala naman ako lahi, hindi naman ako beauty queen na talagang ganda na to, pag-artist tayo natin to. Hindi naman ako Sarah Geronimo na super galing kumanta or sobrang galing umarte. You know, I am but a commoner and as normal as can be. But, you know, of all the people that God could have placed here in this industry, why me, you know? There must be a reason for why everything just were placed on my lap. I didn't have, thank God, I didn't have to line up in front of the BBB house. I didn't have to... You just all the things that you have to go through to get in the industry. And so I really believe that there was a reason for why God put me here. I'd just like to share with you a song that saw me through that whole phase of my life. When I first started when I first started coming out with albums, as a family we made a decision to include one Christian song for every album. And so this was part of my second album. This really saw me through this period. And if you're going through something of the same nature, you might be able to connect. So do give a listen. We, again, have lyrics, if I'm not mistaken. So I think it's the last track. This is called On My Knees. It was originally done by Jackie Velasquez. I think it's the last track. Anyway, so it was very, very difficult for me at that time dahil ang hirap pala talaga. And this is not just for an artist. I'm sure it's also difficult for you guys to be in an industry where maswerte na lang tayo ng ABS-CBN, eh, meron pang morals. But let's face it, showbusiness is really not the cleanest industry to be in. It's not the most wholesome, kumbaga. And I'm sure every once in a while, we are all tempted to compromise our beliefs. And, okay, sige. Anyway, so, do we get into this? So how many of you know that music is really one of the most effective ways to communicate things? I was afraid kasi that I wouldn't be able to say enough. I'm not a pastor, I'm not a preacher, and I haven't done this in a while. And so I thought that music would be kind of like the best way to maybe share with you what I went through. And yes, track 11. Mahirap, pastor, ang hirap pala ng trabaho ninyo, ano? Konting data ko lang, inom na agad ako. Yes, kaya na to. Lapit na natin marating yung ano. Yes, sana ma-achieve natin siya kasi I would like to share with you the song. But if not, I can go on ahead with the rest of my chuba over here. Di ako pwede sa preach sa simbahan. Po? Backup dancer. Tambourine. It's the last, it's supposed to be the last track. No? Oh, it's not. Ah, okay. Or 10. Okay. Anyway, okay, so I'll just go on with the rest of it and then just anytime we're ready. So, I was trying to figure out why, Lord, eto na. So, dito na ako, kung ano na pinagdadaanan ko, pero bakit parang walang rewards? Why am I here, Lord? Bakit? And then, parang ni-reveal sa akin, Lord, don't you see the people who come up to you and ask you for help? People you're not even really close to. Parang for some reason, they find a certain sense of comfort and confidence and confiding in you, in me, na, you know, I just random people that I come mga co-artists or past road managers na nag-open up sila and they seem to feel like I might be able to share with them something based on my perhaps experiences in life, which is not so many, but for some reason sila sa akin lumalapit kahit na hindi kami masyadong close. And so, you know, I find that people open up to me, they ask for advice, and then I realized another revelation that I was sent to the battlefield. I was sent to war. You know, church, that is where you prepare for war. That is where God equips you. That is where you get all the ammunition from the Bible. They prepare you. And ideally, you're supposed to step out of that babying feeling, that comfort zone, and go out and fight the battle. Late ko na na-realize na, okay, wow, yung pala yun. Kaya pala mahirap. Because I was sent to the battlefield. And so, I realized that this was where the real work is. Do you realize that when you're in church, it's so easy to be a Christian?
Yeah.
Diba? It's so easy to, when you're in church, holy sons, yan, mga ka ng Christian. Ito ka lang, mga ka ng Christian. Or you speak Christianese. Or you know, you walk a certain way. You hold your Bible a certain way. You refer to a sister, ganyan, a certain way. Or when you're speaking to a pastor, dumalamot yung voice, opo, yes, pastor. Ganyan, di ba? Alam natin lahat yan. When we're in church, it's so easy to be a Christian, especially when you're right next to, laksan mo lang yung amen mo. Amen! Isipin na nung katabi mo, ay, blessed Christian, bongga. So it's so easy to be a Christian when you're around Christians. But the true test is when you're sent out there. And that is where the real work is. Wala namang masasave sa simbahan kasi lahat kayo ay anong ministra niyo isa't isa, di ba? Lahat namang kayo ay Kristiyano na. So, para saan pang magsistay ka? And that's when I realized that God really had to take me out of my comfort zone. Put me here where it's uncomfortable, extremely uncomfortable, and surround me with people who need help. Or you know, I'm not saying that I'm the Messiah or whatever, but I see myself as an instrument, and I'm sure that you all see yourselves as an instrument that God can use. You will not do the work. God will do the work in you, through you. And so that was what I it was such a revelation to me na kaya pala, ito na, ito yung gera. Andito ko kaya all the years that I was brought up in church, memorize all of these verses, and grew up in youth ministry, para pala dito yon. So that when you're sent to the battlefield, you are ready, hindi ka matitinag, you are strong, and you're ready to fight.